got a one. No, she got a one, baby. Come on,
baby. Money. No whammy. Oh, it slows down.
We home.
Champion edition.
We home.
It's champion edition. Okay.
And I was calling for that, too. I hope he plays Bison. Dude, I really do. Or Guile. It doesn't matter.
Look, I'm telling you right now, champion edition came out. It was so exciting. We could play the new bosses. We could play mirror matches finally. Because literally in Street Fighter 2, you couldn't play mirror match. And so when you guys started a game, people would race to Guile. Player 2 had an advantage because he could get to Guile first.
My goodness. Because they're on that side of the screen. That's so cheap.
Now, they're going to do a button check here really quick just to make sure their buttons are
correct. This is vintage. Stop.
CPS 1. Listen to the CPS 1 music and the sound effects. Still some of the best sound effects. You know, in Smash Wii U put Ryu in the game. They used the CPS 1 sound effects. Made me so happy.
Oh, my goodness. Do you hear how the fireballs clash on the skin? It sounds like a straight slap to the chest.
The thing about this game, though, is that eventually Bison became obviously the strongest character. So I hope someone just psycho crushers and throws and re-dizzies and stuff like that. So.
Oh, my God. You folks at home are so lucky this is semi-esports. I got so many bars in a non-esports fashion for this game. You are so lucky. Oh, man. Oh, this is actually a match?
Is this the actual match?
No, you can't jump on Alex Valle. Come on, son.
Yeah.
I'm going to crack the statue. That was my favorite combo to go to when I was young, just three shorts. I felt so accomplished.
Oh, look at that whip punishing right here, even in the old school games.
Oh my gosh.
Gets the throw in here.
Trap.
Yeah, you're stuck in the corner right here. Now, interestingly enough, this was the first game where Ryu and Ken were actually different characters. In Street Fighter 2, the only thing that was different between them was their kick throw. And Ken would actually roll before he did the kick.
Yeah.
So he was actually slightly, quote, better because he could get corner carry a little bit better off of his kick throw.
Shoot.
But in this one, Ryu's fireball was faster. His Tatsu had invincibility on the way up and down. But Ken also got his fierce flaming uppercut and the fast Tatsu.
You see the spacing?
Yeah.
Yo, Valle.
And keep in mind, too, the stun in this game is ridiculous. If you get hit by a fireball, one more heavy hit and you will fall dizzy. That's it. Fireball and then one hit and you're dizzy. Oh, come on, Valle. Yeah. Tick throw him to death. Do it. He doesn't know how to stop this. He can't reversal.
I don't know how to stop.
He can't reversal. Get him with the tick. Oh, I can see him just baiting him. He was just baiting him.
That was a prehistoric whiff punish.
And, you know,
prehistoric.
And man, back then, this game was like the speed. You could tell, obviously, much slower. And so it's like, how could you not win punishment? Oh, fireball traps? Vi's doing the real. Oh, and he knew he was going to throw the fireball. That would have been a stun. That was almost a stun if that fireball had hit. Oh, he was going for the CPS one chain. That's dizzy. Two hits, you're dizzy, and you're dead. Two hits, and you're dizzy.
Do you see how clean Ryu's feet look when he go up to the skies? Yo, this is so vintage. Yo, I'm so sorry right now. This is actually really cool that I'm actually witnessing this. Especially you alongside, man.
The one of the cool things about this is Vi really didn't come onto the scene until Alpha 1.
Right.
Like, people, that's when he first showed up to a tournament, and he beat Mike Watson in an Alpha 1 tournament, and that's how he made a splash onto the scene. But to be honest, he had been playing all these games in the arcade beforehand. You know, he just hadn't played in a lot of the competition. So even though he's not classically part of the old Pico Rivera scene and stuff like that in Southern California, he knows these games just fine. He knows them just fine.
That's pretty sick. So he was like, he was just the local legend, and then he started traveling?
Basically.
Yeah, okay. That's what's up. The local bully.
No such thing as a local legend back home. Yeah, look at this. Vi is trying to go for crazy CPS one chains, basically. Oh, trading with the fireballs. Oh, yeah, doesn't knock down. You're going to uppercut that for free. And so basically, there's an old school technique where you can chain light kicks into fierce punches. If you hit like light kick and fierce punch at the same time, but you had to switch between standing and crouching and standing. And the people discovered that more around the hyper fighting time, but it worked in all three of the original Street Fighter 2s. Oh, Vi is going for like...
Definitely trying to hit him with the three piece. Absolutely. Yeah. Oh.
Get him with the cross up. Oh, no, not a cross up.
Oh, the sound effects. Oh, strings.
Yeah, I know. These, you don't understand, like...
Oohs.
The sound effects, those hit sounds right there, those hit sounds and the muffly sound and all that stuff like that is like buried deep within my soul. You know, I mean, it is just a part of me.
Trap is over.
Oh, yeah. What are you going to do? What are you going to do? Nothing there. Yep. He had to do a reversal uppercut, but not going to happen. Alex Vaig.